Hi Tashi. I was waiting to do this video till I looked a bit more dressed and appropriate, but then I thought, you always tell me I wear too much makeup. Anyway, so, hey, let me be natural. Also, my baby's crying in the background. Hold on. Okay. Hi. Tashi, I just wanted to make you a video so that you can play this over and over again in case you're missing me or you forget me. I mean, first of all, how funny is it that I'm sitting here with my child? If you can remember back to when we first started becoming friends and all the ridiculous dating stories and psychos and fools I dated and all the advice you've had to give out over the years, who ever thought I would actually get to this? And I think partly I should probably thank you for it, for some of your sage counsel. And also, you were there in the moment I found out that this little butt was inside of me. Suffice to say, Tashi, you're a super important part of my life, and I'm seriously going to miss you. And I'm really sad that you're leaving. But I'm excited for you. I know it's time for you to go back, and I can understand all your reasons why. I just want to make sure you know how much I love you and how important you are to me. And I've joked about it in the past. I've talked about it in team meetings when I made a shield talking about my life and quite lesbian-ish. Your name came up a lot, but it's true because I love you a lot and you've been there for me. You always give advice, whether I want to hear it or not. You've been an awesome boss for the past year and you've helped me have my best year there. And basically you're my go-to for so many things. I just don't know what I'm gonna do without you. Neither does baby G, clearly. I know I'm gonna see you again. You know we're gonna come there and visit you, so I know this isn't a goodbye, and I don't feel sad at the thought of our friendship waning or anything. I'm just sad that I don't get to see you and have you around, and it's gonna be weird to know that, like, you're not. First of all, you're not a few blocks away anymore in my life here, which has already been an adjustment. And I think I've been a little bit in a bubble with my baby, so it's been a little bit at least manageable. And now when life comes back to reality again and I'm back to work, I'm probably really gonna feel just how much I really miss you in my day to day. So please promise that you'll stay in touch and WhatsApp me all the time. I'm proud of you. Congratulations on your new amazing job. You're a rock star, but I always knew that anyway. And I love you, Tashi. Thanks for being you. And I'll see you in Oz. Bye.
Tashi, it's Rockin' here. I was just thinking how you actually coined the name Rockin', so thank you, because it definitely stuck. Wow, I can't believe you guys are actually moving. I know that this has been inevitable, but we all hope that it was never gonna happen. I probably have it a little bit easier since I moved three years ago. So I already see how we've still stayed in touch through that time, and I just appreciate how much you've always shown interest in what's going on with me over here and my family. And we just talked about in Houston how we have a friendship that we cannot see each other for a year and then see each other and it's like nothing has changed. And I think those are the best kind of friendships, and I feel that our entire group of friends is like that. And so I just really appreciate that about our friendship. And you know, I really have said that you are the entire package, you know, brains, beauty, so much beauty, you know, wit, sense of humor, that's you. No, seriously, I know we make that joke a lot, but it is true. You really have so many amazing qualities. It's no wonder that people want you to stick around at Cision and that you have so many close friendships, because you really are just, you kind of have it all. One thing that really sticks out to me about you and is really a defining quality of you is your sense of humor and just your ability to connect with people over humor, even executives at our company and people that you just have this ability to disarm them and say, don't take yourself so seriously. And that's something that you've definitely taught me, and I think our entire group of friends. It allows us just to be silly with each other and make really stupid jokes, but honestly, it's like the highlight of my day when I get to chat with you guys. So, I'm gonna miss you, but not gonna cry because you didn't cry when I left, and I'm still bitter about it, so not crying over here. But I do just want to say I love you. I appreciate you. I'm so excited for this next chapter in your life, and wish you and Nick and Jude and Parky all the best in your move. Love you. Mwah.
Hello, Tashi. Sending you my love from London. And wishing I was there to spend your last couple of weeks in New York together. I can't believe it's real. I keep saying that over and over again. I mean, I still can't believe that I live here in London, let alone the fact that you're no longer gonna be in New York when I get back, which just depresses me. But I know that this was something that was always planned. I knew that this day would someday come, and I'm just sad to see you go because you are so important to me and I really miss you. It's been nearly 8 years, I believe, that we first became friends at Miller Hyman training, where I crawled underneath a bathroom stall for you. That's friendship right there. But we have such amazing memories, and God, I don't want to cry in the middle of the office. I've done that a couple times here, which may just become the norm for everybody around me. But I just think about, you know, all the times that you've been there for me and the changes I've gone through in the past couple years, which haven't been easy. And I know this may not be easy for you either, just going back home but leaving all that you've built behind in New York. But this is gonna be an amazing chapter for you and for the family and being around your family and everything. I think this is gonna be great. And you know, we're gonna have a place to visit in Australia. So there's nothing wrong with that. I love you and I wish you all of the best. And please do keep in touch in the meantime. I mean, I'm sure we will. I hate even saying that. That sounds really like cliche, but, you know, I'm only a phone call away and I miss you so much. All my love to the fam. All right. Bye.
Oh, Tashi. What can I say? It's not gonna be easy to say goodbye to you. I was walking out to grab lunch before and I was reflecting on how different my life is now than it was when we first met. And certainly there are no more fun, boozy lunches, but I am so glad that we got to experience those days together, and I think about them all the time. Honestly, some of the best years of my life, really seriously. Even surpassing the Georgetown days, I must say, in some respects. But really, you are amazing, and the group of friends that we've created together is something that I know we will always cherish and keep in touch, and we'll have to have reunions all around the world. And I'm really sad that you're not gonna be able to make the wedding, but I know you'll be there in spirit, and Rose and I are definitely gonna make a trip to see you and Nick and the kids sometime soon. But it's just, this is not goodbye, and you know, we are all just so lucky to have had you here for the last 8 years. Thank you so much for making the journey and for staying so long, because this could have happened a long time ago, and we're just so glad we had as much time as possible with you. So love you, see you soon, and let's try to rage next Saturday and make this as great goodbye as possible. Love you, Tosh. Talk to you soon. Bye.